Let's pray as we come before God's word.
让我们来到上帝的面前，安静自己。
Father, again, we want to thank you that we can come into your house to worship you. And now as we come to your words, Lord, we pray, Lord, that you teach us. We pray, Lord, that you open our heart and our minds. The Lord, that we will learn from you. That we, Lord, we will live out the words in our life. God, we thank you and be with us. We thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you still remember that we had the Olympic this month?
你们还不记，记不记得刚刚结束的奥林匹克运动会？
Or our Olympic ends when badminton ends?
还是它过去我们就忘记了。
Now I want to share with you today a greater Olympic race.
但是今天我要跟你们分享一个很伟大的奥林匹克赛跑的事件。
And that is our Christian Olympic run.
这是一个基督徒的奥运赛跑。
Let us turn to our Bible to Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and verse 2.
让我们一起翻开圣经，罗马书十二章一到二节。
It's only two short verses, but it's very important from Paul about living or running our Christian Olympic race.
这个经文很短，只有两节。但是是保罗写给所有的基督徒关于怎么样过出怎么样做怎么样赛做一个基督徒赛跑的很重要的经节。
Let us read it together. First, I'll read in English, and Susan will help us to read in Mandarin.
让我们一起来读。
Those of you can read in English, please read together with me. Therefore, I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercy of God.To present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what the will of God is, and which is good and acceptable and perfect.
所以弟兄们，我以上帝的慈悲劝你们，将身体献上，当作活祭，是圣洁的，是神所喜悦的。你们如此侍奉乃是理所当然的，不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化，叫你们查验何为上帝的善良、纯全可喜悦的旨意。
Now, most of us find the reading of the book of Romans very difficult.
很多人觉得罗马书很难念。
Let me help you by giving you an overall picture of the book of Romans so that you can read it this week with a better understanding.
但是今天我要跟你们介绍一下它的大纲，所以接下来一个礼拜你们可以去比较容易的去读。
Now the book of Romans was written by Paul to the Roman church in Rome.
罗马书是使徒保罗写的，他是写这封书信是写给在罗马的教会。
The members of the Roman church then was mostly Gentiles, and very few were Jews.
那时候罗马教会的会友大部分是外邦人，他不是犹太人。
Hence, the letter to the Romans begin by explaining right from the basics.
所以写给他们的书信呢，要从这个信仰的基础开始讲起。
So Paul wrote the first 11 chapters to explain the Christian belief.Or the Christian doctrines.
所以罗马书的第一章到第十一章，保罗花了十一章的篇幅去讲基督教的信仰的教义。
Then from chapter 12 to chapter 15, Paul urged we Christians to live up our life according to our beliefs.
那从十二章开始到第十五章，保罗就鼓励基督徒活出这个信仰来。
Christian living is inseparably connected with Christian believing.
基督教的生活是和他的信仰是不可分割的。
The way we live our lives, our words, our actions and value in life is always an outward expression of our beliefs and thoughts.
我们的生活方式，我们说的话，我们的行为和我们的价值观，都是和我们的内心所相信的是不可分割的。
So Romans is an easy book if we keep this in mind.When reading the book.
所以如果你有这样的一个大概 的了解的话，你就会发现罗马书其实不难。
So Paul said that know what you believe.
所以简单的就是说，保罗说你要知道你所信的是什么。
And he used the word therefore, go and live out what you believe.
然后这一章呢就以所以这两个字开始，所以你要这样子活出你的基督徒的生命来。
That's why Paul starts Romans chapter 12 verse 1 with the word therefore.
所以保罗在十二章第一节就用了这个字所以。
It is the bridge or the signal that Paul is now switching from teaching about Christian doctrines to Christian living out your faith.
所以保罗在这里用了这个所以这个桥接于把过去所讲的那些关于基督教生命信仰的东西还有他的生活方式连接起来。
Believing without action is only head knowledge, a complete hypocrite.
一个没有行为的信心，只是存在脑海里的知识呢，是全然虚伪的。
Very quickly, I will help to summarize the book of Romans without explaining.
所以我会很快的总结一下罗马书，然后我不去解释。
And I hope that this week you will take the time to read the book of Romans for a better understanding.
我希望接下来的这个礼拜呢，你花点时间去读罗马书，是了解更多。
Now, Romans chapter 1 to 11, as I said, is our Christian belief and our Christian doctrine.
从第一章到第十一章是基督教的信仰和教义。
From chapter 1 to 8, Paul explains the fundamental and the foundations of Christian faith.
第一章到第八章是讲到这个基督教的信仰，它的原理和基础。
It starts with saying that God is righteous.
它就以上帝是公义为开始。
It explains God's mercy of divine love for mankind.
它解释了上帝对所有罪人的爱。
Resulting in God's plan for salvation and righteousness for all sinners.
结果就是上帝的拯救的计划。
Chapter 1:18 to chapter 3:20 says about the unrighteousness of all mankind.
在第一章十八节到三章二十节讲到所有不义人类的不义。
Meaning all of us have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
就讲到我们所有的人都有罪，都亏欠了上帝的荣耀。
Everyone is a sinner.
每一个人都是罪人。
Acknowledging one's sinfulness is the first step to coming back to God.
认罪是我们回到神的开始。
Chapter 3:21 to 5:21 talks about the justification by faith.
从三章二十一到五章二十一讲到因信称义的道理。
Meaning that it is not by our works that we, but by our faith that we can come to know God.
意思说我们不是靠行为来认识神，而是靠着我们的信心。
Chapter 6:8 explains that all Christians, because you believe in God. And you have received your forgiveness, you are free from the bondage of sin.
从第六章到第八节，第八章讲到说，所有的信徒，因为你因相信了，你就脱离了罪恶的捆绑。
Chapter 9:11 talks about God's sovereignty over salvation.
从第九章到第十一章讲到上帝对救恩的主权。
Meaning that only God has a right to grant forgiveness of sin.
意思讲说只有上帝有权利赦免罪恶。
If you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart a person believes.Resulted in righteousness, and with the mouth he confesses, resulting in salvation.
你若口里认耶稣为主，心里信神叫他从死里复活，就必得救。因为人心里相信就可以称义，口里承认就可以得救。
Then Paul goes to Romans chapter 12 to 15 to talk about Christians live out your faith in the way you live, both in the church.And in the world.
然后从第十二章到第十五章，保罗就写基督徒你要怎么样活出你所相信的，在教会里面和在教会在世界里面。
So in chapter 12, from verse 1 to chapter 15:13, Paul talks about firstly in chapter 13 how you should live out your Christian life among Christians in the church.
然后在第十二章就讲到一个基督徒在教会里面应该怎么样做。
And chapter 13 talk about how we Christians have to live in this world.
然后第十三章讲在世界里面应该怎么做。
As we are now coming towards Merdeka, how as a Christian we must learn to honor our country and to pray for our leaders of the country.
特别是在我们来到这国庆日之前，我们作为一个基督徒的，应该要怎么样对待我们的国家？
Then chapter 14 to 15 talks about that as Christians, how are we going to treat other Christians that are weak or other Christians that are strong?
那这第十四到第十五章就讲到，我们做基督徒的应该怎么对待那些软弱或者是坚强的肢体。
So that by our life we will be an encouragement to others and not a stumbling block to other Christians in their Christian faith.
使我们的生命可以成为建造别人的生命，而不是拦阻他们。
And it ends with chapter 16. We talk about commendation and greetings.
然后第十六章就是一些的赞扬和问候。
Let us get back to our Bible today, to Romans chapter 12.
让我们一起回到我们的今天的经文，罗马书十二章。
After the word therefore,
在讲完了所以这两个字以后，
Paul ends his Christian teaching and begins with Christian living.
保罗就讲完了他的基督教信仰的那些原理，接下来就是讲基督徒的生活。
Paul starts with, I appeal to you, brothers and sisters.
他保罗说：“我以上帝的慈悲劝你们。”
The older versions will say "brethren."
旧的版本的圣经会说弟兄们。
The New Living Bible say "I ask you from my heart."
第新译本会说我从心里呼求你。
In the dictionary, the word "appeal" means to make a serious, urgent, or heartfelt request.
呼求就是 说打从心里里面要求某些东西。
Now you don't hear the word appeal from your friends or even relatives.
你不会从你的朋友或者亲戚口中听到这句话这个字。
For many of us, if you want to do lo, if not, who cares?
对我们很多人而言，你要做什么就去做了，反正也不关我事，
对吧 ？That's how we always think, right?
我们的想法基本上是这样。
But here.Paul say, "I appeal to you from the bottom of my heart."
但是保罗在这里说，我从打从心底里劝你们。
To do what?
做什么
？So if you hear such heartfelt requests from, you only hear such heartfelt requests from your dearest.
你只会从你最亲爱的人口中听到这样子的。
From your parents,
可能是从你的父母
your wife,
可能是从你太太
your husband,
你的丈夫
and now from Paul,
然后还有保罗
Now with such appealing words, there's no reason why we will not do it.
所以如果有听到有人这样子深情的跟你说这句话的话，你大概要听。
And Paul says, I appeal to you,By the mercies of God,
我是以上帝的慈悲来劝你们。
Because of the mercies of God given to you, I appeal to you.
因为上帝给你的这些慈悲，我劝你们。
Paul is referring back to what he have taught in the first 11 chapters.
保罗的思想一定是回到他之前所写的那十一章里面。
Of all the mercies that God have shown to you to bring you.Out of your sin into salvation,
就是上帝花了这么多的慈悲，这么的恩典来救你从罪恶里面出来。
Paul used the plural word of mercy.
保罗在这里用的那个慈悲是多数形式的。
That is, God has been showing mercy to us a time, many a time, many a time.
意思说，上帝在不同的时间里面都给了我很多的恩典。
And that God's mercy is continuing being poured onto us today and tomorrow.
上帝的恩典在今天、今时、今日仍然的临到我们。
And therefore, I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercy of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice.
所以弟兄们，我以上帝的慈悲劝你们，将身体献上，当作活祭。
Your bodies,
你的身体。
Meaning every part of your life.
意思说你的生命的方方面面。
Your soul.
你的灵魂。
Your body.
你的身体。
Your mind and your will.
你的思想，你的意志。
All of these have to be given unto God.
你所有的这一些都要献给神。
Now what is soul?
灵魂是什么？
You see, Paul used the word brethren when he addressed the Romans.
他保罗写信给罗马教会的时候，他用的是弟兄们。
不是好像我们现在用啊，和 Along to call me, hello, Dilo, hello, brother. You know, the Along will still call me a brother. That thing. That's not what Paul meant.
也保罗的兄弟是不一样的。
Nowadays you call one another brother, sister. That thing, right?
今天你随随便便就叫另外一个人是弟兄或者是姐妹。
The word brethren is only used in the Bible to represent those who have accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior.
在圣经里面使用弟兄这两个字，通常是指那些已经接受主做基督做主的门徒。
Meaning Paul is reminding you as Christians.You have given your soul to God.
意思说他写信给这些基督徒，告诉他们，提醒他们说，你们是把已经把灵魂献给主的人。
The second is our body.
第二是我们的身体。
All the components of us as a human.
我们所有的像一个人的所有的部位。
Our physical body.
我们的肉体身体。
How we think.
我们怎么想的。
And how we reason.
我们怎么样去思考的。
Every part of our body has to be offered up as a sacrifice unto God.
我们的人全人都必须献给主。
The mind.
我们的思想。
If you don't give your mind to God,
如果你不把思想献给主神，
you are not able to sustain giving your body to God for long.
你们是不能持久把身体献给主的。
If you don't program your mind properly, you will soon.Remove your body from the altar of sacrifice.
如果你不好好的控制你的思想的话，很快你就会把现在祭坛上的身体拿回来。
The will,
我们的意志。
The mind formulates the thought.
我们的思想构建了我们的想法。
But it is the will that will ensure our body carries out the action of our mind.
但是是我们的意志，是我们的身体能够去做那些思想决定的事情。
All these four elements of our body.
这个我讲到我们身体的时候，就包含这四样。
Your soul, your body, your mind, your will.
你的灵魂，你的身体，你的思想，你的意志。
Must be fully offered as a living sacrifice.If we are to be fully submitted to God in worship,
如果你想要在敬拜中全然的向神降服的话，你就必须把这身体的所有的部分全然献上，当作活祭。
Now, what is living sacrifice?
活祭是什么？
The idea contains in sacrifice is that of a dedication.
献祭的目的就是要把献上。
If you know the Old Testament, you will know that there's always the sacrifice that you bring before God. You know.
在旧约里面就记载人必须怎么样把祭物带到上帝的面前献给他。
In the New Testament, we are talking about Christian dedication.
在新约里面就讲到基督徒的献身。
Christians are to dedicate our bodies, meaning our whole life, to God.
基督徒要把自己的全人献给神。
Not only once as if in the Old Testament, but the daily dedication of our bodies, energy, and give directly, consciously to God's service.
不是像旧约那样久久才献一次，而是在新约的时代里面，天天的把自己献上。
Not to do evil or to speak evil.
不要讲那些不好的话。
But also to do good.To your neighbors and to God.
也是要对自己邻舍对上帝好。
Holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship.
圣洁，神所喜悦的，就是讲到我们属灵的敬拜。
Now we talk about dedication. We talk about holy. It means without blemish or defect.
我们这节讲到圣洁，意思说是没有瑕疵的。
And this is the word that is used in the Old Testament for sacrifice.
这个字在旧约里面讲到那些祭物。
Right? The animals that is be sacrificed before God must be without blemish nor defect.
你带到上帝面前当作祭物献上的动物必须是毫无瑕疵的。
No other sacrifice is acceptable to God.
而没有其他的祭物能够被上帝悦纳。
We are to give to God our best faculties.
我们必须把我们最好的献给神。
The vigor of our mind, our talent and time.
我们的才干，我们的时间。
It is to be without sin, undivided, and no partial service.
之所有这些献给上帝的，必须是全我们的全部，而且是没有瑕疵的部分。
Complete.
完全。
We give ourselves to God as our sacrifice when we understand first God's grace, God's mercy He has given unto our lives.
我们之所以能够完全的献上，因为我们首先我们明白了上帝在我们生命里面所施舍恩典。We
offer ourselves not ignorantly.
我们不是出于无知而献上。Without
understanding.
我们不是出于因为不明白才献上。
Like animals brought before the slaughter.
或者就像那些动物被牵到宰杀的人面前一样。
But we offer ourselves intelligently and willingly.
而是我们明明知道我们献上是什么，而我们现在来了。
This is the worship that pleases God.
这是这样子的敬拜，这样子的献上才是蒙神悦纳的。
This is the worship that is acceptable to God.
只有这样子的敬拜才是上帝所喜悦的。
What is spiritual worship?
属灵的敬拜是什么？
It is a devotion of worship that takes the form of self-dedication, holiness of life, pure in action to love God and man.
是自我奉献的形式的灵修敬拜，生活圣洁，行为纯洁，爱神和爱人。
Let's go back to Romans chapter 1 and 2, chapter 12, verse 1 and 2.
我们再回到我的经文。
Romans chapter 1, 12, 1 and 2 says that what it really means for a Christian to fully worship God.
这讲到说一个基督徒真正的敬拜是怎么样的敬拜?
The Christian life is to be primarily an act of worship.
我们基督徒的生活应该是一个敬拜的生命。
Which is to give of ourselves as a living sacrifice.
是要把自己的身体 我们的全部献上，当作活祭的一个敬拜。
The correct response to the many mercies that God has given to us is to give a spiritual offering, a living offering, a daily offering of ourselves as a sacrifice unto God.
所以我们领受了上帝的许多的恩典，他的慈悲以后，唯一的回应他的方式就是把自己全然的献给他。
Worship is very much more than singing praises to God.
敬拜不只是唱歌而已。
It's not the 10 minutes in the morning you pray down, you worship God. That is not the full meaning of worship.
也不只是早上你所花的那10分钟而已。
Worship is giving your full life to God.
真正的敬拜是把你的生命的全部献给他。
Giving your total life to God.
把你生命的全部献给他。
Our life, our youth, our wealth, our will, our talent, our everything to God in thanksgiving.
我们的生命，我们的青春，我们的财富、意志、才干，还有我们全部在感谢当中献给神。
Everything that we have given to God is worship.
你把所有你所有的东西献给神，这才叫敬拜。
Not come to Sunday for the 15 minutes of singing and shouting and praising. That alone is not enough.
不是只是来教会的10分钟才是敬拜，那10分钟不够。
Christian life is not about what you can get from God.
基督徒的生命从来不在乎你从神那里能得到多少。
Christian life is about what you will give to God.
基督徒的生命是关在乎你把什么东西献给神。
Christian life is about what you will give to God.
基督徒的生命是 在于你把什么献给神。
It is about complete surrender.
这应该是完全的臣服。
Of ourselves to God.
是把我们完整的献给神。
A daily living and holy sacrifice of a complete self.
是我们把完整的自己，还有把我们的生活献给神。
If you can put this into your mind,
如果你有这样子的想法
and live it out in your life,
然后活出这样的想法
you have understand the essence of Paul's teaching and purpose in the book of Romans.
你就是真正的明白保罗在罗马书里面所讲的道理。
So Romans is not that difficult to understand.
所以罗马书其实并不难懂。
Right? Understand what you believe.
明白你所相信的是什么。
Live out what you believe.
那你就活出你的想法来。
That is Romans.
这就是罗马书。
Let's continue. Let us look at the words. Let's look at the word conform and transform.
然后接下去让我们看效法还有更新变化。
Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind.
不要效法这个世界，只要心意更新而变化。
What is to be conformed?
效法是什么？
Conform is to blend into the world.
就是融入这个世界。
To be politically right in our actions and our words.
就像你所讲的话，你所做的事情都是政治正确的。
To follow the social norm.
去符合社会的期望。
So many Christians, we live outwardly, I believe and accept as acceptably by the society.
我们很多基督徒都活得很符合这个社会的期待和要求。
But inside, we say in my heart, I am a Christian.
但在心里，我对自己说，我是一个基督徒。
God is between me and God, man.
我的信仰是关于我在我跟上帝之间的事情。
So outside people know or don't know, never mind.
外面的人知不知道不要紧。
Is this acceptable to God?
上帝希望你这样吗？
If you behave and act like this, soon your heart will grow cold towards God.
如果你是这样子过你基督徒生活的话，我相信你的心再过不久就会冷下来。
I want you to look at the three pictures down there.
我要你看看出上面的三个照片。
Do you know what is this?
你知道这三片照片讲的是什么？
Do you know what is Pride Month? Pride Month. Pride. Pride.
Pride.骄傲月
right? Do you know what is the symbol of the rainbow flag?
那个彩虹旗是什么意思？你知道吗？
啊 ？LGBT 啊 ？All the LGBT people, LGBT A B C D E. Is it? Because the pastor used so many letters, I cannot remember. I can only remember LGBT A B C D E. They believe that the rainbow represents them. Any type also can.
LGBT 的群组就认为这个彩虹旗代表了他们的身份 LGBT plus ABCDE、
right? The Pride Month is celebrated in June every year
在人们在七月的时候庆祝这个骄傲月
六月、right? So if you go holiday when you, in June especially you go to Europe you go to Taiwan when you see all this happening on the road don't get a shock
所以你在六月出去旅游，在台湾、在欧洲的话，你不要惊讶。
You will see all the decoration, all the rainbow, and including the church everywhere, government building with the rainbow.
你到处你都会看到彩虹旗，在教会里面，在政府部门。
Now to conform to the world,
你效法这个世界。
Many of us, many of Christians, we will come out and celebrate this together with them.
很多的基督徒都出来一起跟那些。LGBT 的群组一起庆祝这个日子。
I don't think when you come out to celebrate, you say that you are LGBT.
当然，你出来的时候，你不会说你自己是 LGBT.
You are just having fun.
你只是跟他们分享快乐。
Or conform to this world. That's what the Bible says.
或者效法这个世界，圣经就是这么说你的。
That is what we meant. The Bible meant by conforming to this world.
当圣经说你效法这个世界的时候，就是这样子做。
Conforming to what is happening, conforming to what the society believe and the society norm.
我们融合于我们周遭的社会，我们融效法他们。
Now the second picture in the center is a church in Bristol, UK.
在中间的图片是英国的某一间教会。
Last year I was in UK and believe me, many churches put out this flag in their compound.
去年我去了一趟英国，我发现很多的教会都挂上了这个旗。
Very sad.
我感到很悲伤。我很失望。
I checked internet. This church in Bristol, it says that you can be both LGBT and a Christian. You are welcome.
在教会的那个网页里面说，你不管你是 LGBT 还是你不是，你都欢迎来我们的教会。
The church conforming to the world.
我们的教会，这个教会效法这个世界了。
What about you? What about me?
你和我又怎么样？
How are you conforming to the world?
我们怎么样效法这个世界？
Last year I went to York in England.
去年我去了英国的约克镇。
I went to visit this so-called historical church in York.
我去了这个约克镇里面一个很古老的教会。
It is famous because they have what we call a box pew, meaning that in the church. They have a lot of boxes. You know,
在这个教会里面有很多的箱子。
And each family, you sit in the pew inside the box.
在一个家庭，你就坐在这个箱子里面。
Meaning that if it is one family, you have one box.
Okay, 一个家庭你就有一个箱子。
If this family, you have this box.
另外一个家庭你坐在另外一个箱子。
So it's very unique, right?
是很特别。
So I went.
所以我就去了。
So at the garden, I saw that plaque.
在花园里面我就看到了这个标志。
You know what is written there? Can you read what is written there?
你上面写的什么呢？
Unfortunately, I put it too small because it says that Anne Lister, 1791 to 1820.
上面写的是 Anne Lister, 从1791年到1840年。
Lesbian.
她是一个同性恋者。
Took sacrament here.And seal her union with Anne Walker, Easter 1834.
在1934年复活节的时候跟某某人结合。
Anne married Anne. Well, both of them had the same name, okay? One is Anne Lister, one is Anne Walker.
一个名字，另外一个名字。
Right. Two ladies.Marrying together in the church.
两个 Anne 在教会里面结婚。
The church is so proud. This is the first lesbian marriage in the church.
那个教会非常的骄傲，说这是在我们教会举行的第一个同性的婚礼。
The church conforming to the values of the world.
这个教会效法这个世界的价值观。
I ran into the church.
我进去了这个教会看。
Gloomy and dark.
里面是昏昏暗暗的。
I can tell you, I don't know Sunday got people go on.
我不知道礼拜天有没有会有来经崇拜。
If you don't honor God, God leave.
如果你不崇敬神的话，上帝会离开。
I think there are no Christians in this church. God has left the church long ago.
我相信上帝已经离开了这个教会。
Are you conforming to the world?
你是否也效法这个世界？
Are you not afraid that God is going to leave you?
你害不害怕上帝离开你？
But Paul says, be transformed.
但是保罗说你要
transform.
你要变化。
From the inside, renewal of the heart and your mind.
你要从心里面开始，心意更新而变化。
To be changed like from a caterpillar into a butterfly.
像从一个毛毛虫变化成一个蝴蝶一样。
A totally different. Can you recognize the difference between a caterpillar and a butterfly?
你能够分清楚毛毛虫和蝴蝶有什么不同吗？
Of course, you study your science, you know. Right?
如果你读理科的话，你像大概你就能明白。
But you will never realize that ugly crawling worm will turn out to be a very beautiful butterfly.
你从来想象不到一个在地上爬的一个毛毛的毛毛虫，居然有一天会变成蝴蝶。
And that's what Paul is asking of you.
这是保罗要求你做的。
To be transformed by the renewal of your mind.
你要心意更新而变化。
To a new orientation of life's purpose.
使你的生命的目的从此改变过来。
Resulting in a change of thinking and behavior that will be pleasing to God.
使你的行为，使你的一切都能够被上帝所悦纳。
Transformation comes from knowing the divine truth of God as given in the Word of God.
从上帝的话语明白上帝的要求是什么，然后我们更新而变化。
How do you renew your mind?
我们要怎么样才能更新我们的心意呢？
You renew your mind through the reading and understanding of the Word of God.
只有去读上帝的话，去明白上帝的话，才能做到。
Meaning, read your Bible.
意思说你要去读圣经。
The Word of God is a source of renewal of the Christian mind and values.
上帝的话是我们基督徒的思想和价值观更新的源头。
You have to saturate your mind with the divine truth.Of the Bible.
你必须用圣经，圣经所记载的真理来充满你的思想。
There is no shortcut to this.
这个方法是没有捷径的。
You have, if you want to know God's view, you have to read the Bible.
如果你想要明白上帝的心意，你就要读圣经。
Your belief and the values of life is in proportion to the time.You spend reading and understanding God's word versus your time spending absorbing the values and system of this world through all means, such as the television, the internet, songs and music of the world.
你的价值观和你所信仰的事情是跟你读圣经的时间和读关于这个世界的消息而成正比的。
Meaning you spend more time on such things and less time on the Word of God, you will soon be conforming to the world.
如果我们吸收这个世界的知识和讯息越多的话，很快的我们就会效法跟随这个世界。
Our mind is the battlefield.
我们的思想就是我们的战场。
Where the spirit of the world fights with the new nature, the divine truth.That the Holy Spirit implant unto you through the understanding of the will of God from the Bible.
在这个战场里面，这个世界的灵和我们新的生命会征战。
That you may prove what is the will of God, what is good.And acceptable and good and perfect.
叫你们查验何为神的善良、纯全和喜悦的旨意。
That you may prove.
叫你们查验。
Prove not in the sense that you validate God, meaning that you don't prove God.
查验并不是说我证明了有神。
But in the sense that you demonstrate the will of God through your life.
而是指我们用我们的生命来展现上帝的旨意。
What is the will of God?
那上帝的旨意是什么？
The will of God is as written in the Bible.
就像圣经所记载的。
We can begin to understand God's purpose in our life when we begin to read our Bible.
只有在我们开始阅读圣经，我们才能开始理解上帝对我们的人生的计划。
Good, acceptable, and perfect. That the will of God for you is good and acceptable and perfect.
上帝对你的计划是善良的、纯全和喜悦的。
And you have to show it to the world by living it up to demonstrate that God's will is good and perfect.
而你要活出这样子的生命来，使世界上的人可以看见上帝的善良、纯全和喜悦的旨意是什么。
I'm going to share a testimony with you.
我要跟你分享一个见证。
A testimony of this famous guy.
就是一个很出名的人。
You may know him.
你可能听说过他。
He's a gold medalist in the 1924 Paris Olympic.
他是1924年巴黎奥运会的一个金牌得主。
Exactly 100 years ago.
就准准100年以前。
So who is Eric Liddell?
埃里克·利德尔是什么人？
He's a Scotsman.
他是苏格兰人。
Born in Tianjin, China in 1902.
但是他是在中国天津出生的，他的父母是基督教的传教士。
He died in Weixian, Shandong, China in year 1945 as a missionary and teacher.
那1945年他以宣教士教师的身份在中国山东省这个潍县去世。
In Paris 1924, Olympic gold medalist and world record holder.
在1924年的巴黎奥运会，他得到了金牌，创造了世界纪录。
A graduate from Edinburgh University in chemistry.
他毕业于爱丁堡大学化学系。
A committed Christian and a teacher and a missionary in China.
他是一位虔诚的基督徒，也是一名教师和中国的宣教士。
对吗？Can I have page 13, please? 我是看不到的。
是。
Thank you. Okay, let's look at his life.
那我们看看他的生平事迹。
Paris 1924 and the conscience of a Christian.
在1924年举办的奥林匹克运动会，还有一个基督徒的觉醒。
A few months before the Olympic, Eric received the schedule for the games.Some of the dates for the heats and final for the 100 meter, 4 times 100 meter and the 4 times 100 meter fell on Sunday.
在奥林匹克开幕前的几个月，埃里克就收到奥运会的热忱安排，100米、4x100 米还有4x400 米的预赛和决赛，有些部分的热情是在星期天。
You all know him, no? You all know the movie Chariots of Fire, right?
你可能听过火战车这个电影。
Da na na na. You have heard the song?
你听过这个这首歌吗
？Chariots of Fire. If you don't, you're much younger than me.
如果你没有听过的，表示你还很年轻。
Eric announced that he will not take part in all the races that falls on the Sunday. Sunday is the Lord's day, and it is reserved for worshiping God and His services.
埃里克就宣布说，他不会参加在所有在星期天举行的比赛。因为星期天是主日，是用来专门敬拜上帝和做礼拜的。
There's no reasoning or decision required.
他不需。
Eric has decided long ago in his life. God comes first above all else.
他不需要任何的理由或者是任何其他的原因来做这个决定。埃里克从很久以前呢就已经决定了，他的生命在他的生命里面，上帝高于一切。
Not even his favorite event, the 100 meter race. He was actually the favorite to win the gold medal.
即使这意味着他不能参加他最喜欢、最擅长的100米比赛，虽然他是当时最有希望赢得100米金牌的人。
With this announcement of not running any race on the Sunday came lots of criticism and pressure for Eric to change his mind.
在埃里克做了这样子的决定和宣告以后呢，他就遭遇到很多的批评，批评他为什么不能参加星期天的比赛。
Pressmen hammered at his university dorm door, demanding that Eric take part in the 100-meter race.
就有人在他的那个宿舍外面就挂一个纸牌，要求这埃里克参加比赛。
Even calling Eric a traitor of his country.
甚至指埃里克是国家的叛徒。
Pressure from the British Olympic Association emanated forms of threat, but Eric took no notice.
英国的奥委会也威胁他，强迫他，但是埃里克一概不理。
Eric refused to contemplate competing on the Sunday, and he started training for a 400-meter race.
他就决定了不参加这个100米的比赛，然后就开始为400米比赛来做准备。
It was never his strong area.
400米从来不是他最擅长的项目。
A favorite short distance runner giving up his favorite 100 meter for a 400 meter mid distance race that he don't stand a good chance even to win a medal.
在他一个擅长短跑的选手去参加一个400米中长距离的赛跑，他是没有什么希望可以赢得奖牌的。
That is Eric.
Eric 就是这样子的一个人。
Holding to his conviction and Christian belief.
他坚守他对上帝的信仰。
What about you and me?
你和我又怎么样？
Are we conforming to the world?
我们效法这个世界了没有？
Or are we living a life of sacrifice?
还是我们活出一个对世界看来是一个牺牲的生命？
The day of the race.
在比赛的那一天。
Friday, 11 July 1924, Paris.
在1924年7月。那一天
For the 400 meter race, Eric was drawn to run in the worst lane.
在400米的比赛 ，Eric 就抽签跑到一个最差的跑道上起跑。
The eighth lane, where the runner cannot see the rest of the runners up how the rest of the runners are performing.
他在第八跑道，他没有办法看到其他的比赛的参加者。
When the starting gun was fired.Eric shut off in the blistering speed as if he was still running his 100 meter race.
这个发令枪一响，他就以惊人的速度出发，就像他跑100米一样。
Flashing past the 200 meter in 22.2 seconds.
在第22.2秒就冲过了200米。
Suddenly, as he's switching to first gear, Eric threw his head backwards in his distinctive style. He stretched his lead.And ended up finishing the race 5 meters above the racing pack.
之后呢，艾利克就抬起他的头后昂，然后就继续的跑完这个比赛。
He found his second win. He found his third win. You know sports, right? You run very tired already. Then you have your second win. Wow, go luck, bro. Then he had his third win, even more luck. He ran and he finished the race.
然后以加速度的方式来完成了这个比赛。
The finishing time was 47.6 seconds.
时间是47.6秒。
An Olympic and world record that was not broken for another 12 years.
在这里，在这一天，他创下了奥运会还有世界的记录。这个记录一直到12年之后才被别人打破。
The next day's newspaper in London headline read, "The Flying Scotsman."
在第二天的那个报纸上面写着说飞翔的。苏格兰人这个标题。
Later, when asked about his tactical approach, in his own words, he said,
在后来，当记者问到他的那个赛跑的方式
，Well, when the gun goes, I go as fast as I can, and I trust to God that I will have the strength to do the second half. I think my God really did.
他说。当枪声响起的时候，我会尽可能快地跑。我相信上帝，就是我将有力量完成下半场。我相信上帝做到了。
We go now to Eric living his life committed to follow God's calling and will.
Eric 立德尔，他用他的生命表现出怎么样去跟随上帝的呼召和他的旨意。
To the world.Eric Liddell was born to run.
对世界来说，李艾瑞天生是为奔跑而生。
But to Eric Liddell, God made me for China.
但是对李艾瑞来说，上帝让我为中国而生。
Below there are some of the photos, of the Olympic.
然后接下来下面的就是艾利克的照片，还有
newspapers
在报纸上面的。
He said, "God first."Then Olympic record follows.
然后他说：“我先遵从上帝，奥运会的记录才跟着来。”
Eric Linder, God's medalist, gold medalist, 1924 Paris Olympic.
艾利克里德尔，1924年奥运会的金牌获得者。
Not for crowds, not for country, not for fame, not for glory. He ran for God.
他不为荣耀，不为金牌而跑，他为上帝而跑。
After the a few months after the Olympics,
在奥运会之后几个月
Eric left behind all the fame of the athletic life, potential wealth, glory for the life of a teacher and a missionary in China for the rest of his life.
Eric 离开了他的家乡，也放下了他很可观的事业，然后去中国做一名教师。
You want to know more about Eric Linder? The book is in the library. It looks like this.
Okay, 如果你想对这个李艾瑞的生平了解更多，你可以去跟我们教会图书馆借这本书。
Let's look at Eric's life in China.
然后他的在中国的生活。
First, Eric worked as a science and sports missionary teacher at the Anglo-Chinese College in Tianjin.
他一开始是在天津这个英华书院担任科学和体育的老师。
Both the school and teacher and Eric believe that the best gift to China is to teach the children of the rich Chinese families.
学校和埃里克都认为说，能够给中国带来的最好的礼物，就是为这个中国富有的家庭教导基督教的价值观。
To teach them Christian values so that when they become future leaders, China will be blessed.
这样子，当他们长大以后成为中国的领导人的时候，中国会得到祝福。
In 1934, Eric married Florence Mackenzie, a daughter of a Canadian missionary parents, and soon they have two daughters.
1934年，他和另外一他和富兰伦斯结婚，他也是一个一对加拿大的传教士的女儿。很快的，他们就生下了两个女儿。
We know that in China during this era is very difficult.
在这段时间的中国非常困难。
And things got worse in 1937 when Japan invaded China.
在1937年日本人入侵以后就更糟糕。
But in 1937, Eric insisted in carrying his missionary work even to a more dangerous war-torn village called Zhaojing.
Okay, 在1937年，艾利克决定到一个更加危险的地方做老师。
In 1941, during the war, the UK government advised all British nationals in China to leave.
1941年，英国政府就呼求所有在中国的英国人离开。
Eric decided to stay put while Florence, now pregnant with a third daughter, set sail with their two children for a safer life in Canada.
艾利克决定留在当地，而让已经怀孕上第三个女儿的妻子还有另外两个孩子离开。
Eric would never see them again.
从此以后，艾利克再也没有见到他们。
Not even meeting his youngest daughter.
他也没有见过他最小的女儿。
In those era, there's no first WhatsApp.
那个时代没有。
So he cannot call and listen to the daughter's cry or to see her face.
他也不能打电话去听女儿的哭声。
That was the extent of Eric's sacrifice.
这是艾利克所献上的祭。
In 1943, Eric was imprisoned in the Japanese internment camp in Shandong province.
在1943年，艾利克就被关押在山东的日本的集中营。
It is here serving the 1,500 inmates of adults and children that Eric was most remembered.
在这里，他为1,500名成人和儿童的囚犯服务。
He was in the same difficulty like the rest of them.
他也跟他们一样困难。
But he chose to serve by giving of himself.
但是他愿意献上自己来服侍他们。
So that others might experience some hope and joy.
使别人可以从他身上这里能够得到一丁点的快乐。
He taught the children's chemistry and tell Bible stories.
他教孩子化学，还有讲圣经的故事。
He organized sports activity to bring joy.
他也组织体育的活动，为孩子们带来快乐。
Finally, on the 21st of February 1945, Eric died in prison from brain tumor.
在1945年2月21日，艾利克在这个集中营里因为脑瘤去世。
Eric Linder lived a life fully surrendered to God.
李艾瑞过着完全降服于上帝的生活。
Let's look at the last words of Eric.
这个是艾利克的遗言。
Spoken to his fellow missionary, Anne Buchan.
他跟另外一位 宣教士所讲的。
At his deathbed, Eric said, and it is complete surrender.
这个是在他临死之前说的。他说：“安妮，这个是完全的降服。”
That was Eric's last breath. He soon went into a coma and never recovered.
这是艾利克的最后一句话。之后呢，他就陷入昏迷，再也没有醒过来。
Eric Linder, an Olympic and world record holder for the 400 meter race in Paris 1924.
李艾瑞1924年巴黎奥运会400米赛跑的奥运会和世界纪录保持者。
But he was foremost a Christian that lived out his Christian faith.
但他的身份，首先他是一位践行基督教信仰的基督徒。
Not conforming to the values of the world,But been transformed by the renewal of the mind.
不效法这个世界，而是心意更新而变化。
Living a life fully surrendered unto God to bring out what is good and acceptable and perfect for the glory of God.
他过着完全臣服于上帝的生活，展现出什么是善良、纯全和喜悦的旨意，以荣耀上帝。
Eric Linder said.
李艾瑞说,
It is not sufficient to admire Christ. It is not sufficient to love Him. For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Cried Paul, Apostle Paul in Philippians 1:12. That is the spirit which in work for God has to be done.
李艾瑞说，光是欣赏基督是不够的，光是爱他也是不够的。对我而言，活着就是基督，死了就有益处。这个这，他照着这个是使徒保罗在腓立比书一章二十一节所说的。
We cannot end by showing what China appreciates of Eric Linder.
李艾瑞去世之后，中国是怎么来尊崇他
？Eric Linder honored in modern China.
在新中国里面。
The prisoner of war camp which Eric Linder died is now a school of 2,000 China teenagers.
李艾瑞去世的所在的战俘营呢，现在是一间有2000名学生的学校。
Every year, all the new pupils in the school is taught about the camp and Eric Linder's achievement on and off the track.
在学校里面，每一年都向新生讲。这个艾利克的故事，还有他在这个学校里面所做的一切，
在 on the running track in the Olympic and his missionary work。
他的参加奥林匹克比赛，还有在学校里面这个战俘营做的。
This part of history is a great treasure of our school, said the headmaster Zhao Guizi.We see great values of humanity, especially in Eric Lindell's story.
这个学校的校长赵桂霞说，这段历史是我们学校宝贵的财富，我们看到了人性的巨大价值，尤其在李艾瑞的故事里面。
Because he was born in China, some people regard him as the first Chinese Olympic gold medalist.
因为李艾瑞出生在中国，所以有人甚至说他是中国的第一位奥运金牌得者。
It's not a joke, said Wang Hao, Wei Fang's director of foreign affairs.
这个探访室的外事长局长这样子说。
In the same school, you see that they built a statue and a plaque in honor of Eric.
在这个学校里面呢，也为这个李艾瑞建了的那个曾经住过的那个牢房外面建了一个铜像。
And they want to build a museum.And reconstruct Linder's prison and Eric in the wax form inside the prison.
他甚至想为这个李艾瑞建一个博物馆，里面放他的蜡像。
It will be a remarkable honor for a Christian missionary in a communist country.
这个在一个共产的国家里面，这样子去尊荣一位基督徒是很不寻常的。
In closing,
最后。
We need to worship God by living the life set before us in God's will.
我们需要按照上帝的旨意来过我们的生活。
leaving the result in God's unchanging hands.
你把结果交给上帝。
Whether working as an engineer,
不管你是一位工程师，
a business owner,
你是位老板，
as a missionary or a teacher in school,
你是宣教士或者是老师，
or caring for an aging parent, the goal is the same.
还是你是在照顾年长的父母，你的目标都是一样的。
Total submission to Jesus' will.
你要完全顺服耶稣的旨意。
A daily surrender and living sacrifice.
每天降服并献上自己当作活祭。
The Christian Olympic race is not a 100-meter race.
基督徒的奥林匹克比赛不是100米。
Not a 400 meter.
不是400米。
Not even a marathon race.
甚至不是马拉松。
It is a lifelong race until the day we die.
而是一场终身的比赛，直到我们死去的那一天。
A daily complete surrender and living sacrifice of our whole self for the service of Jesus Christ.
每一天为着耶稣基督的侍奉而完全降服，并献出整个自我。
Let's pray.
我们一起祷告。
Father, you have saved us by your many mercies upon our life.Help us to present our life unto you as our living sacrifice of worship. Help us not to conform to the values of this world, but be transformed by the reading of your Bible, that we may prove you, that your will is good and perfect to the world by the way we live our lives. God, may your grace and your mercy be upon each and every one of us.We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.